such a hand, everybody. We can just hang here. Amen. This is getting bigger and bigger. And man, I'm telling you, God is up to something. He's doing some great things for me. He's doing some great things for you. And one of the things that I found out, amen, when you are living this type of life, there's no need to be jealous. And then lean on somebody, so I ain't mad at you. You know what happens? Most times God blesses your neighbor to show you what he's getting ready to do for you. And the only way that you can get what you see, you have to be happy for what you see. And not be jealous of what you see. And become envious of what you see. Amen. So I want you to know today that we are all sitting in heavenly places together. We don't have too much time in this room. Amen. But we are excited. It has been a great 2 days of meeting yesterday and today. And we got a few more things to do today. But it's going to be off the chain. Amen. How many of you glad that we made it here this morning? I'm glad. Amen. For those of you who don't know, my name is Bishop Hezekiah Walker. Amen. And I come to you every afternoon with the afternoon praise. The Hezekiah Walker Show. I feel happy to listen to our show. Every day we live in DCC, we try to bring you the very best in gospel music. And so we thank God, and we come on every Sunday morning, amen, on WBLS, amen, at 5 a.m. So those of you, if you're up on Sunday mornings, you can listen to Bishop Hezekiah Walker on Sunday mornings on WBLS, amen, on 7.5 at 5 a.m. Amen. I am looking for God to do some great things by the end of the year. Amen. Amen. So between today and December 31st, I believe that my world is going to turn around. Amen. I really believe that things are going to happen for me. Everything that I have prayed for, everything that I have ever hoped for, I believe that this is going to be my year. I'm looking forward to stepping into 2017 with my miracle in my hand. Amen. How many of you are looking to step into 2017 with your miracle?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Okay. I'm going to give you this word today, and I hope and pray that it will encourage you. I've been praying all week about what to say, amen, to the people of God today. So I'm going to give you, amen, a text, one verse that the Lord has given me, and I'm going to give you what God has given me to give to you, and I pray that you have an ear to hear what God is saying. Those of you who have your Bibles, amen. Those of you that did not bring, I brought my Bible with me. Amen. Some of you have it on your phone, but how many of you brought your Bibles? We still carry your Bibles, right? Thank God. How many of you got your Bibles on your phone? Oh, wow. Great. That's good. How many of you don't have a Bible, period? You don't have a Bible on your phone? All right. Just a few hands up. Amen. So we need y'all to get those Bibles on your phone. You need to be able to read that on the train, on the bus. Amen. Yes. You gotta carry it every like that America's press card. Amen. Don't leave home without it.
Amen.
You gotta have it. So listen, we're gonna go to 1 Samuel. Amen. We're gonna go to 1 Samuel and we're going to go to chapter number 30. 1 Samuel chapter 30. And we're gonna read one verse. We're gonna read the 8th verse. 1 Samuel chapter number 30, verse number 8. Repeat that. 1 Samuel, chapter number 30, verse number 8. And this is what the word of the Lord says. And David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue? Everybody say pursue. After this troop, shall I overtake? Everybody say overtake. Shall I overtake them? And he answered him, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all. I'm going to lift that verse up again. And David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And God answered him back and said, pursue, For thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail you shall recover it all. I want to talk to you from the subject this morning, go after it. Go after it. With some serious eyes, I need you to look at everybody in your row and tell them with an urgency, tell them to go after it. Find somebody behind you this time and tell them, did you hear what I said? I command you to go after it. We are living in a critical time.
Amen.
We are walking around, amen, here in America. We are uncertain about the next minute, about the next hour. We are unsure about that presidency. We don't know who's going to take it. But I told somebody last night, we already know who's in it.
Amen.
How many of you know God is already in the seat? Your hands is up until my faith open. You better tell your neighbor, God is already in the seat. And it actually doesn't matter who wins. You know why? Because we got a God that's on our side.
That's right.
I ain't got nobody over here. It doesn't matter who takes the seat.
Right.
You know why? Because Trump nor either Hillary is putting food on our table.
Amen.
You know who's putting food on our table? God is doing it. He said that I will be Jehovah Jireh. I will provide. You want to tell your neighbor, God is providing for me. I know everybody sitting here, some of you think that your job is doing it. And I thank God for my job. And I thank God for my boss. But my boss is not my supplier. My job is not my supplier. You know what David said? David said, I look to the hill from which cometh my help. I need somebody in here. For my help comes from the Lord. Can I tell you something, sisters? Sisters, we are always going to eat. You better help somebody in your room. Put a big smile on your face and say, we are always going to eat. We are always coming. You better say it. Some of y'all not saying it. Some of you scared. You scared, but the devil's a liar. Get your mind off of Trump. Get your mind off of Hillary. Get your mind off of the government. It is God who has made this world, and it is God who's going to protect it, and it is God who's going to protect us. We will always eat. We will always have food on our table.
Amen.
We will always have clothes on our back. If he did it before, God got it over here. You better give somebody a high five and say, I ain't worried about nothing.
Yeah.
Jesus is right there all the time. He said, I'll be with you in the sixth trouble and in the seventh trouble. I don't know what's forsaken. I need somebody to understand, amen, that God is always on our side, whether we're up, whether we're down, whether we're in, whether we're out. Look at your neighbor and say, we always protect him. Always protected.
Always.
We're always covered. Believe it or not, you're covered right now.
Amen.
You're covered right now.
Amen.
As we approach the text this morning, we see here, now David, let me give you a little history of the text. Here the text says, David has left his home, his family, his children, and he took a troop with them to go with him to go out and to obey God. And as he was obeying God, the enemy came to his city and captured his wives, his children, and all of the men that was with him. They took their wives and their children as well. And when David got back to Ziklag, not only was his family missing, not only was his kids missing, not only was the troop that went with him, amen, not only was their family missing, but the Bible said that the Amalekites burned Ziklag down. So when he got back, not only didn't he have, he didn't have his children, but he didn't have a place to lay his head because everything was on fire. It is a terrible thing to do the right thing and always the wrong thing happens to you. It is a terrible thing to treat everybody right, and it seems like the more you love on people, the more people will hate on you. Have you ever extended your hand to people and people cut your hand off? Have you ever been kind to people and the people that you were kind to were very mean to you? Well, I got one. Have you ever loaned people money? And when it was time for you to get some money, nobody had none. Y'all ain't saying that. Have you ever loved somebody and you was expecting for that same kind of love to come back? It's a terrible thing to be in love with somebody and they don't love you the way that you love them. But you know what I found? That I'm not loving nobody in this season of my life that's not willing to love me back. I ain't got nobody over here, so let me talk to you. But you get your name and say, I'm not willing to love nobody that's not willing to love me back. This time, when we come to the table, we both have to come to the table with something. I'm not just going to come to the table and bring everybody. I'm not that thirsty. You're going to keep on taking from me and never giving. The devil is a liar. Amen. This is not this season. I love me. I love me some. Anybody love you some of you? My God, you can help somebody to understand. Say, I love me. I love me. Come on, look, some of y'all are not saying it. You probably don't love yourself. But before you leave out here, amen, you're going to start loving yourself. Because if you don't love you, don't expect nobody else to love you. Just yet, thank God, but I feel I need to talk to y'all face to face. to do what's right, and you always get wrong back. And you know, what I think one of the worst things is, I mean, I could probably deal with it from outside people, but when you gotta deal with it
inside.
Yeah.
Because I want to see if it works. Everybody sit down. And what I want everybody in this room that just said the name of Jesus works, I dare you to say it as loud as you can say it right now.
Jesus!